He got out that way in an identical situation in Chennai.
Full highlights, if we must, of the third day's play coming up shortly in the show. Now, Tasmania is in a spot of bother heading into the second day of the Shield final against West Australia at the Wacker Ground in Perth. Booney's side made a great start. At one stage, they were 2 for 174, but a dramatic collapse. Now sees them really struggling. Jamie Cox carrying the hopes of the Tigers. He's unbeaten on 96. Full highlights of day one of the Shield final aren't too far away here on the show. Now let's take a look at the National Rugby League, and Penrith supporters will have the chance to welcome back Mark Geyer this afternoon in the match with Canberra at the Penrith Football Stadium. There are three games on tonight, with the Gold Coast hosting Parramatta at Carrara. Balmain is away to North Queensland, while a big crowd is expected for the Newcastle-Auckland clash at Marathon Stadium. Last night, it was an upset win for North Sydney over the Sydney City Roosters at the Sydney Football Stadium. The Bears scored 3-1 to take the match by 18 points. Now, the game didn't start all that well for North. They lost playmaker Ben Eichen in the opening minutes with a leg injury, but they made sure it didn't affect them too much. Gary Larson, an unlikely first try scorer for the Bears, showing a real turn of pace for a front rower to touch down underneath the posts. And it was another forward scoring the clincher, Adam Muir, taking North's beyond reach.
Oh, Rickardson's lost it. Muir's on his way for the line. Muir's going to make it. And Adam Muir, in his second game for his new club, puts it over the line.
Full highlights of the North's Sydney City match coming up shortly here on the one and only Wide World of Sports. Australia's Wayne Riley leads the field after two rounds of the Portuguese Golf Open in Penina. Riley shot a blistering second round of 66 at 12 under. He's two shots clear of Scotland's Paul Laurie. Radar Riley, as he's affectionately known, fired four birdies in his last five holes. He certainly lived by his name, both with the irons and the putter, to put himself in an extremely strong position with two rounds to play. Tiger Woods leads the field after the first round at the Bay Hill Invitational Tournament in Florida. After a rain-affected opening round, Tiger leads the way at 8-under. The best of the Aussies, Craig Parry at 2-under. Stuart Appleby is two shots further back. But with just 3 weeks before he defends his US Masters title, the Tiger is in great form. The world number one has been in contention in every event that he's played so far this year. Amazing. New South Wales has suffered a setback heading into tonight's vital Super 12 rugby clash with the Northern Bulls in South Africa. In form halfback Chris Whittaker has pulled out of the side with a flu virus, his place taken by Sam Payne. The National Track Cycling Championships continued in Adelaide overnight, and again, Darren Hill was dominant, the West Australian grabbing his fourth Australian Kieran title, but only just.
Position, Colquhoun goes for home. He'll get the bell lap now. It opens up a big break. He's out by 10 metres, second Clark. They're followed by Kirsten. Here comes Sean Eadie. On his wheel is Darren Hill, who makes his challenge. Eadie, the rider on the scene. He moves up on the outside. Darren Hill is flying. Eadie in front. Hill's coming at him. He's flying. And, well, tight go. He may have just got there, Darren Hill.
Yes, and we'll catch up with Darren in just a moment. Plus, we have full highlights of the championships coming up. Now, some mixed results for the Australians in the first round of the Lipton Tennis Championships in Florida. Mark Woodford had no trouble with American Jermichael Gambill, while Michael Tebbutt beat Sandon Stolle in three sets. No luck for Jason Stoltenberg, gone in straight sets in the first round to Spaniard Gallo Blanco. And the young hotshot of the Aussie summer, Leighton Hewitt, also a first-round loser. Scott Draper made an exit in three sets, while in the women's first round, Kerri-Ann Goos down, also out in three. Now, Pat Rafter and Mark Philippoussis both seeded, of course, and have first-round byes. Well, there you are, Nicole. You're looking very good.
You always make me feel good. Thanks, Bear.
It's a pleasure.
After the break, the latest from Australia's backs-to-the-wall battle in India.
On On A Current Affair, the father who cared too much.
She's only 15 years old.
Jailed for rescuing his own daughter off the streets.
Threw me in the paddy wagon.
Now she forgives him, but the law won't.
It wasn't worth putting him in lockup.
Plus the remarkable woman saving Chinese bears.
It's quite the most appalling thing we've ever seen.
Crammed in tiny cages in the name of Asian medicine.
So much pain and so much infection.
And now she sets them free.
Beautiful.
And our exclusive with Titanic's Leonardo DiCaprio when Nissan presents A Current Affair.
Bicycles are cheaper at ACT Bicycle Superstore. Why? Stock buying power. They're the biggest in Canberra. No one gives you more choice because no one stocks more. Buy any type of big brand name bike from the basic to the elite machines. Technical expertise. ACT Bicycle Superstore is where many of Canberra's elite triathletes buy their bikes. Need we say more? Put ACT Bicycle Superstore on your list or else it could cost you heaps more.
Gentech Generator's robust industrial Honda-powered models provide economical, reliable, clean power for campers, builders, farmers and in fact anywhere where portable power is required. Contact your dealer now on 1800 248699.
Looking for great March savings? The answer is Tandy for a portable colour TV with a...
That's a good kick. Rucker, Anthony.
And what we didn't see was Inderson slip. It was... Well, the umpire, I don't know whether he paid the mark. I don't think he called play on. I think it was never a mark. But Inderson slipped and Rocker ran into the ball. Well, he's kicked two. His confidence should be up. His rhythm's up.
Won't be many more pressure kicks in this than any one player out there today's had.
This for Collingwood to hit the front. Now, just watch him at the back of the goals if this is anywhere near straight.
Look at the post.
Didn't kick that with the same motion, did he? He didn't quite get through the kick, didn't quite drive it, but, well...
Do you want a more dramatic finish?
I don't think we can find this.
Interesting to see what Melbourne do here. Do they go long to hide, or do they just try to use the ball for possession?
Settle down, Lee.
Oh, I thought they'd missed in between. Now, that was a good composure. Out, short, wide. The get-out kick, wide to the back flank.
This is Uzay.
Now it's a question of who to go to. They need to push their players across.
He's been told to go. Johnston may be one of the flyers at the back, but he slipped. Play on was the call, and it's pushed towards the line as precious seconds tick down. But Melbourne making another change. Schwartz is back out onto the ground.
Well, that's an interesting call.
Ingerson off.
Knew they put Bishop to half back on Rocker.
Here's Kosciuszko. Down to half forward. Good mark by Scotty Crowe.
The Collingwood forwards have started to play in front and the ball's dropped short. They've been rewarded.
The moment of truth now for Collingwood. Rocker couldn't take it. Godden shrugs one tackle.
Loves these.
Rocker bends it back, but not enough. And even the goal umpires a wry smile.
Well, you reckon the pressure's on Melbourne now. They've got this lead on the scoreboard. But the Collingwood team are just, the momentum seems irresistible with a couple of minutes to play.
1.5 minutes to be precise remaining.
And have a look at Tony Shaw on the edge of his seat, and rightfully so.
Crowd is an absolute buzz. Here's Todd Viney, the skipper.
They've got no one to kick it to. Wright has to get across.
He's trying to take charge.
Whoa! Sure. Sorry to be ruin and ooin', Sandy, but this is just...
Well, I've never seen you this excited. I think it's great.
Collingwood players must man up here. Must man up.
Ragone still in the back pocket. Kicks it long and high. We're down to a minute left. Big pack of players. Jeff White does the roving at the front. Anthony Rocker farms it out. Just pushes it towards goal. Godden's hand pass a little loose. Anthony Rocker goes again, but he can't take
great
it.
Great strength.
That's straight. That is dash. That is marvellous play. Leon Chelly, well done. Up towards left half forward. Schwartz has been quiet. It's belted away from him, but it has saved some time. Well done, Leon Chelly.
Yeah, terrific play by Leon Chelly. He really attacked the ground level ball, picked it up in a real aggressive manner. He knew that his intentions were, and he just released the ball out of the danger zone for the time being for Melbourne.
Tony Shaw's just tapping the desk, cool and calm. Oh, what a porky pie that is. Schwartz, high, inside 50. Smith, the flyer. Enough to get frequent flyer points, but not high enough to hold the ball.
And it's it's man-on-man situation all over the ground from Melbourne's point. Collingwood have tried to get a, got to get free hands on this boundary throw-in and try to set it up from this part of the ground.
They've got half a minute to do it. Melbourne lead by a point. Trying to do it for Jim Steins. Here's Johnston. His kick is smothered. Burns gets a short kick. They are dog-tired. Phoebe ridden into the ground. Picks himself up. Gets it off to Leoncelli. Leoncelli, well done. He's clear. He shoots. It's a behind.
Well, we know that there's about 14 seconds to go, but the players, all they know is on the time clock, it's almost 30 minutes, and they really have to have one. They've got one surge down the middle of the ground. I think Nathan Buckley's played on.
Listen to this as we come to a conclusion. Richardson's going to have to fly. Can't take the mark. Viney is steady. Johnston's got it. The youngster can seal it forever. He shoots towards goal. It doesn't matter. It's all over. Melbourne are victorious.
What a game, Sandy.
Sensational.
And that's what footy's all about. There's no doubt about that.
You won't get a better game than that.
Unfortunate, there has to be a loser, but the Melbourne team, they able to experience the exhilaration of victory tonight. Collingwood, the depression of defeat. Scott Crowe, he was terrific for Collingwood when he went to the forward line in the second half. He just gave him that extra ground level support. Chipped in with a lot of crucial possessions. Anthony Rocker, terrific last 10 minutes of play. Really sparked the Collingwood revival.
Neil Danaher. He went to the Hall of Fame with his brother Terry last night. They would have had a couple.
I think he'd want to crack a smile, but it's very hard to crack a smile after a tense game, I can tell you. It just takes a while for the facial muscles to relax enough. But
I thought there was a slight sigh of relief.
Relief, that's the word. And certainly when they had the four-goal winning margin, I mean, to...
Yeah, more on that in a moment. Let's go down to the 250 game of Jimmy Steins with Johnny Russo. John?
Steinsy, congratulations, mate. Yes. Fantastic effort.
Best win I've ever played. It was unbelievable.
It was funny. At the end of the game, you weren't on the ground, but I knew you'd run as soon as the siren went.
Yeah, it was hard. But the boys did the job. It's all that matters. Once we're still standing, we're still winning when that siren goes.
Well, mate, it must be a fantastic feeling around the club at the moment.
Yeah. It is brilliant. But that's just another game, but I'm going to bloody enjoy this one.
Well, I know you don't want to stay with me, so go and join.
Yeah, look at Neil Danaher with young McDonald. He's a breath of fresh air for football, Neil Danaher.
Yeah, Sandy, what odds would Jimmy Steins be having a Guinness tonight?
And they're going to do the tradition now in Melbourne, tradition of singing the theme song on the ground in front of their race.
We might see if we can pick this up. Let's have a listen. There it is, Melbourne home in an absolute thriller.
Greg's changing careers.
Oh my God, he's going into entertainment more.
Guess again, mother dear.
I'm going to be a chef.
A what?
Now he's free to do what he wants.
Spending more time with you.
Hey.
But he's not the only one with itchy feet.
You see how we can update the style and still keep it classic?
I blame you.
The comedy that will charm the socks off you.
What would you think of me as a redhead?
I thought you'd never ask. I'll get the colour chart.
Dharma and Greg, 8 o'clock tonight on Prime Television.
When you need a pro who knows the facts to fix your vehicles, electrics on the road will get you back. Fuel injection, diesel batteries, tune-ups and air. The perfect solution for everyone out there. Who can you trust to do all that? Call your local Bosch bloke. He knows.
Call 1-800-060-060 for your nearest Bosch automotive service dealer.
Call your local Bosch bloke. He knows where it's at.
Looking for sensational leather deals? For 4 days only, this leather suite is $14.99. That's $14.99. Or this leather suite with timber trim, just $19.99. That's $19.99. Sale finishes 4 p.m. Monday at LSW.
Thank you for telling me how much you enjoy my Dilma tea. Let me show you why Dilma tea is so different and so...